Just with those hands to Jesus. He alone is worthy to be praised tonight. Are you here to praise him? Are you here to worship him? Just wave those hands to him. Wave those hands to Jesus. It's a privilege to be here to worship God with you. And I tell you something, the testimony that you will receive tonight, 30 years from now, you'll still be enjoying it. That is if Christ tarries. The blessings you're receiving tonight will remain with you. Just give him praise. To worship him. I tell you something, you know, even as you're recording with your phone, I don't want you to be distracted. You know, you don't want to go home with just pictures and videos. You want to go home with something tangible. Who wants to go home with something tangible tonight? He alone is worthy to be praised. Give him praise. Wave those hands to Jesus.
Father,
Alpha and Omega.
Alpha and Omega. I give you praise.
Lift up your voice.
He is Alpha, Alpha, Way. He is Alpha,
Way. For the grand mind of things.
Oh,
God has been good to you this year, just wave those hands. If God has been faithful to you,
yes.
Many started this year, but not everyone is here today, but you are here.
Yes.
It is worth thanking God for. Say, okay, Nedu, give him praise.
Lord, you reign forever, you're the same. I got my truth, give my mind. Everyone say,
Mama,
you lifted me and gave me a song. I got my truth, give my mind. Everyone say,
Mama,
oh, Korobia, Nima.
Champions do we have in the house today? How many champions do we have in the house? Sorry, I think I'm too loud on the monitors. The microphone is too loud. The keyboard is as well too loud on the monitors. How many champions do we have in the house tonight? If you're a champion, make a joyful noise! So did you come to church with your champion dancing shoes tonight too? Who is ready to dance like never before? Are you sure?
Make a joyful noise.
Tell your neighbor to give you some space. Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready? Then do your dance. Let me see. Is this the best you can do for God? Hey, hey.
Put your hands up. Yeah.
You have received tonight, no demon will take it from you. But I stopped because I want to use just 1 minute to share something with you. Please. First, I want to thank the man of God for the unusual love he has for me. I tell you something, it's the type of love that I have never seen before. And I'm not saying it just because he is here. You know, when people truly love you, you will know. I don't mean like the ones who call you to tell you I love you. But the ones who do things to let you know that they love you, you know. Sometime last year, his organization was having something. It was a bank, the bank. And he wanted me to come and minister. Man of God, sorry I'm sharing this testimony. It is my testimony. So he called me to come and minister. So I left, you know, where I was living on the island like 2 hours before the event. And I was in traffic. So we kept talking on the phone. Where are you? Because the event is not prolonged. It's a short, they will soon close. So we kept communicating. You know what happened? I was actually in that traffic. And the event ended. And then we spoke on the phone, and then he said it was okay. And I left. Two weeks after, I was traveling. And I met him in the plane. You know what he did? He said to me, Frank, you know that event I invited you for? I already wrote a check for you, and it's still here. Please, you can still have it. Somebody here, may you receive uncommon grace. May you receive uncommon grace. You know, and we are not talking about, it was not a small money. And I was like, hold on. I did not attend the event. I missed the event. And 2 weeks after, not 1 day after, not 2 days after, 2 weeks after. You know, Pastor, I just want to say before this congregation that the kind of love that you have shown me as a person, I may never be able to repay you, but I will try my possible best. I'll keep praying for you. Anything in my ability to do, to let you also know that I love you, I will do it. The love. My time is up, but I need to, the love is too much. Then I think it was in December. He invited me for another event. It was a big event in December. So something happened. And I couldn't make it. And he was not happy at all. He called me, he was not happy. You know, I was thinking, hey, I don't finish. Pastor is angry with me. So I tried to explain to him what happened, but I mean, I disappointed him and he wasn't having it. I just prayed to God. I said, Lord, this man of God has been good to me. And this is definitely not the best way to say thank you. Please help me talk to his heart so that he can understand what happened. And then just sometime, maybe 3 weeks ago, after a very long month, I just received a call. I looked at the phone, I said, no, it's not. I had to clean my eyes to make sure it was the man of God calling me. I said, sir, and he said, what are you doing on the 25th? I'm not doing anything. So immediately I told him, I'm not doing anything. I just had to call, canceled everything that I have booked, what the thing that, you know, I'm just sharing it for a reason, for you to know the kind of pastor that you have. If you have a pastor like this, you are a champion indeed. Make a joyful noise!